Hi everyone, this is Karthik from Evora.
Hi, everybody. This is Bill from Evora. Some of you may recognize us. Karthik and I have both been in this mobile space for a long time, working with a lot of SAP mobile applications. And today we are going to do a quick review of SAP's new Service and Asset Manager release 2210. And Karthik will start us off.
Thanks, Bill. One of the first features we want to talk about is background auto sync. This is one of the most requested features that we've had from our customers. Basically, what it does is you can have a time sync now in Service and Asset Manager, so you can set up a time where you want the application to synchronize. This is a really good feature because now you don't have to force the technician to do a sync, but the sync happens automatically in the background.
That is long awaited. I think they've also added some automated syncing features to make it easier to programmatically make the application sync and minimize that the user has to sync and give the ability to resync or sync when people come into coverage. So adding some non-batch sync, automated sync functionality is great.
Yep, I agree.
You know, Karthik, one of my favorite new features is the consolidated work order completion screen. Let's take a quick look at it. This is a feature that was requested by many of our customers. And in previous applications like Work Manager, we created this for quite a few of them. So here, let's take a quick look at it. When you complete a work order and the technician is clocking out and doing the completion process, instead of having a lot of okay buttons, yes, no buttons that pop up in the message boxes. Do you want to enter time? Do you want to put in your notes? And those things, it's now consolidated into one screen, which makes it really easy for the techs as they do this. They can come in and put in their time. They can also, what's really nice, is go to the notification and come in and enter the the breakdown information, all of the parting groups, damage codes, all that in the work order completion process. And to me, of this change, like that is the biggest value add, because a lot of people would complain that technicians were completing work orders without entering the notification information, because before this, you had to navigate intentionally to the notification, go fill this stuff out, and then come back and do the work order completion process. So this is a great new feature, and a great extension to the process flow of the application that I think is going to be well appreciated by the user community.
That's right, Bill. This is a feature we added custom to a lot of our projects, but I'm really happy to see this is part of the standard now, and we don't have to do custom screens for our customers.
Definitely. It'll definitely help people, especially down the line. Another new feature is the ability to filter and look up parts that the technician needs for today. In the vehicle stock area, there's now a new filter, which is parts needed for today. If you click on that, it'll restrict that list to parts that the technician has for work orders that are assigned to them for today. It's a great feature and will be really helpful for technicians. One thing I've noticed though is when you do a demo, if your work orders are not for today, because maybe they're from last week or a month ago, or they're out in the future, you won't see anything in this list. So it might be a good thing for SAP to add that to be a little more a filter where you could pick today, tomorrow, the next day, or pick the date in it. Because even a technician might be looking to plan ahead and see what materials they need for tomorrow based on the work that they have. New feature is nice, but maybe a little the ability to pick a date could be a little more helpful.
It's definitely a step in the right direction, though. One of the big features from this release is the smart form integration. This is something new that SAP started off. You can have dynamic forms now, but this is integrated with FSM. So you build the form engine, everything in FSM, and here you would also need an FSM license.
Yeah, I think this is a great kind of first start in bringing forms in to Asset Manager. But as you said, Karthik, you got to have FSM. And this is the most confusing piece of this every time I've heard it explained. You have to have FSM. The forms are built in FSM, and then you could use them with an asset manager. If you want to do forms alone in asset manager, SAP has something on the roadmap for 2310. We'll see what that materializes as. Or you could look at using something like Murata forms to do the forms within asset manager. But the as exciting as this sounds, it's required. You have to have FSM, and that's sort of the could be the stumbling point for some people.
Yeah, that's right. It's a good first step, but all the data from the forms, the inputs will be stored in FSM, and you need to see everything there. Out of standard, there is no integration with SAP, but this is also something that partners like us can build.
Just a quick comment on the inventory persona functionality. Within this release comes the ability to do reversals. SAP has kind of continued within each of their releases to add more and more functionality. And I think now they're pretty close to being on parity with what was in the old SAP Inventory Manager application. So it's in good shape now. And I think it's something that the customers will start to adopt is pretty much everything you need should be there. What's missing, you know, go back to the good old SI who can adapt and add in other stuff.
Yeah, Bill, as you said, it's coming really close to Inventory Manager. And I think we also start talking to some of our customers to start implementing the inventory persona.
Yeah, excited that it's there now. Next, let's talk about a few things that SAP's added that frankly you may not notice are there, but when they weren't there, you notice that they were gone. So one of these is adding in the PRT long text. Who knew it wasn't there? Just when you look at it, you look at the demo of the app, you don't see a lot of these things. But as you talk to your customers, these are things that pop up. And it's great that SAP is finally adding some of them because it just means a little less customization for every customer. So one's the PRT long text. One is the user statuses, a key to the process. It's good that the technicians on the mobile side will be able to see them now. Also within the operation, the plan duration and the number of technicians, just a couple extra fields, but it can be good, meaningful data for people to have. Any from you, Karthik?
Yeah, there's also now the possibility for long text templates. So when the technician is completing the long text, you can also have a template here. This was always available in the backend, but now you can bring that configuration into the application as well. I think this is a really important feature, and we see that many of our customers could start using this. Another small update is with maps. In the past, you could always only see a single object, like an equipment or a work order. But now, if you have multiple objects with the same geo-coordinates, you can see that in a list, and you can select the one which you want. I think this is a small feature, but quite effective.
Yeah. Those are good things to have.
Bill, perhaps we should talk about Windows support.
Ah, the long-awaited Windows support.
The first version will be finally released next month. We see that most of the features are there. Some features that are not there is the map support. I think the other features are quite small. We encourage all of you to have a look at it, play around with it, and see if you can already start using the Windows 1.0 version. After the Windows 1.0, there's also a new version that will be released with 2305, which would have more features there.
And then right after 2305, the plan is 2310 should be on feature parity with what's currently available in the iOS and Android versions. So next fall, end of the year, the final version will be out, and then it should be good to go. So, but as Karthik said, I think it's now it's time, there's something there. So it's now time to take a look at it, get a feel for what's there and start to evaluate it. I'm excited that it's here because it's been a long time coming for the Windows client. A lot of customers still need it. So hopefully we'll get it going now. So there's a quick summary of what's new in 2210. Karthik, any last words?
Thanks, everyone, for listening.
Thanks, everyone. Enjoy your day.